Hey guys, I'm nickmeister and welcome back to Let's Play LA Noire. And it's been a while since I played this game. I kind of like to record in spurts, so I don't know, I might do another case after this, who knows. Let's see here. What's next? Right. And okay, so Marriage Made in Heaven. And next one is A Slip of the Tongue. I don't even remember what this one's about, so this should be fun. Has anyone tried San Pellegrino soda? It's really good. Really good. A slip of the tongue. That's all it took. Oh, great, this asshole.
Phelps, Bukowski. B-Cop says he located a green Kaiser Frazier from the hot sheet. Address is 6 West 2nd Street. Get over there and see what you can find out. Go on!
Sorry to inconvenience. Well, you're not forgiving, you fucking asshole.
We're on it, Captain.
Alright, so this is actually, I think, my first hard one. There's a lot of clues, a lot of false leads, and a lot of things that just don't really make any sense, but, well, we'll make it through.
I swear, the more bent cars we bring in, the longer the hot sheet gets.
It pays the rent, though. It keeps Mrs. Phelps in the manner to which she's accustomed.
I'm not sure she'd agree with you.
Passionate, romantic type like you, Cole? I don't believe a word of it.
Hey, so, yeah. Actually, it's one of my least favorite ones, because I always seem to fuck something up, but maybe I'll get lucky this time. Alright.
You're behind the wheel.
They're calling her the Dahlia now. Wonder what Veronica Lake makes of that one.
What a case. You hear whether they're making any progress?
Captain Donnelly seems to think they have it all wrapped up. Brown and Green are sweating this Manly character. I heard it'll be in front of a grand jury by next week.
Poor thing. Terrible enough being murdered like that without having her death strewn all over the front pages.
Not that she'd know, because she's already dead. Alright, what are we looking at here?
That's the car, Cole. Shit. Just pulling out of the drive. Get him!
You make me drive, huh? Alright.
Remember, we need him healthy enough to
man.
Answer questions.
I guess that means I can't shoot him in the head.
1247, Detective Phelps.
So I think there's an achievement for stopping this guy before back of the ride. So let's see if we can do that. Although I think I already got the achievement, so whatever. Yeah.
Come on.
And yeah. Alright. Oh, come on! Can't believe they didn't stop him.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
Get out of that car, you fucking asshole. Before I shoot me in your goddamn fucking head.
Maybe that was a couple miles over the speed limit.
Show me your hands!
Get bracelets
out of the car now!
I'll call it in.
Why did you run from us?
I saw a big car in my rearview mirror with two tough guys bearing down on me.
Pull over,
what would you do?
What's your name?
Cliff Harrison.
Hear the siren.
You're under arrest.
For what? What are you talking about?
Nice try. I'm talking about the car being stolen.
You're out of your mind. I bought the car, and I've got the paperwork
show
to prove it.
Show me the paperwork, you douche. Look at that guilty motherfucker over there.
Looks like we'll have some questions for the people at Coombs Automotive.
Isn't that kind of racist? Cliff Hannison? Harrison? Something? I don't know. Okay. Kaiser Frazier. Huh. They used to come on right before The Simpsons, right? I never watched that show. Manhattan? Let's see. $2,400, huh? Must be a rich kid with rich parents. Alright, well, everything looks on the up and up here. I guess we'll just have to interrogate him a little bit. There you go. See, 24 years old. When I was 24, I was still riding the train. I still ride the train now.
You purchased this car from Coombs Automotive Company?
Yeah, that's right.
What are you, racist?
And the ownership papers?
From the same place!
If this is a forgery, it's top notch. This will need to be traced.
Alright, so this seems like it's, on the up and up here. Then why, pray tell, did it come up stolen? That's what we gotta figure out. Alright, why'd you run away?
You have a criminal record, Mr. Harrison?
No, nothing like that.
White guys, they're all the same. Alright, so this guy's a fucking liar.
You better give us something, Cliff, or we're gonna make this hard on you.
I didn't steal the car. I ran because I've got some wacky-backy in the glove compartment.
How much, Cliff?
One reefer.
Wacky-backy.
We'll let it slide. You're in enough trouble.
Wacky-backy. Wonder if that one will make a return, right? It's kind of boring now. Everyone just calls it weed.
Who did you deal with at Coombs Automotive?
The owner, Richard Coombs.
All right. It's kind of a dumb name, but...
And he made out the bill of sale, personally?
Of course he did. He kept a facsimile for his records. Check with him.
We're going to get to the bottom of this, Harrison. Until we do, you're going downtown.
You gotta be kidding me! I'm getting arrested for buying a goddamn car?
If everything is legit, Harrison, you'll be out soon. Until then, if I were you, I'd keep my
mouth
shut.
Bag his possessions as evidence, and have him arraigned for grand theft auto.
There's fucking marijuana in the car.
You know
who my
father
is? He's driving
around
like a fucking lunatic.
We need to get to Coombs Auto.
You gonna
and
let
check
him off?
Harrison's story.
Seriously, come on, man. Excuse me. What are you doing? You don't belong in there, pal. Hold on a second. Yeah.
You can drive. Do we know where we're going?
Going to Coombs Automotive. Weren't you even paying attention? There you go. That's it. Slide over. All right.
You know what? I think he's telling the truth.
Some of the most convincing people you will ever listen to are born liars. Usually they're called politicians.
Well, considering how that guy's father was a rich man, he probably will be a politician someday. Get a little more water here. Oh great, it's another fucking car salesman. I wonder if this guy's got any doobies. That other guy didn't give me any.
Not another step. I have got a Buick Century sedan that would be absolutely
perfect for you. Don't tell me what to do, you fucking jerk.
Detective Phelps, LAPD, are you the owner?
That's right. Richard Coombs, at your service. You looking to trade in a black and white, boys?
Mr. Coombs, we're investigating an auto theft. A man by the name of Cliff Harrison claims he bought the car here.
Well, some people would say that my cars are a steal.
Very suspicious.
Very amusing, Mr. Coombs.
I remember Harrison. It was a green two-tone Kaiser Fraser, if I remember rightly.
Do you have the bill of sale?
It's in my office. Walk this way.
I think that was a new joke back in the 1940s.
That's a joke too, son.
Phelps, you mind if I shoot this guy? He's getting on my nerves.
Actually, no. I think that joke's from like the 1840s. Jesus. All right. Careful with that joke, it's an antique. What the fuck is this? Sherman's? Those candy bars or something? You selling candy bars? For your basketball team? That's a common thing people do. Alright. There. Finally figured out how to get into my chair.
There it is. Got the original pink slip there too.
Let's take a look at these shits.
Unfolding paper.
Okay. I guess this is a carbon copy or whatever.
Harrison's purchase receipt was legit, at least.
Yep, it's for real. It's for real, son. Wonder if, Gene Archer.
Gene Archer. 146 North Fremont Avenue.
Alright. So, I'm back. Alright, is everything in its place, Cole? I think it is. Alright.
We have a couple of questions.
Alright, fellas. Shoot.
That guy's head looks like it's in, like, a fake suit, the way his neck bobbles around. Okay.
You're as thick as a whale sandwich,
what
aren't you, son?
What the fuck was that supposed to mean? Oh, okay. Whatever.
Can you tell us how you came to buy the car?
Girl just wandered in right off the street.
Alright, think that's truth.
Nothing unusual about the car.
Not really my usual type of vehicle. The price was certainly right, though. Nice girl, but about as sharp as a bag of wet mice.
Did you pay with check or cash?
A check. She wanted it made out to cash, but I insisted. Man has to watch his cash flow.
What name?
I made it out to Gene Archer on the Bank of Arcadia.
Okie dokie.
Can you describe this Gene Archer?
Brunette, maybe 25, 26. A little on the plump side, but not bone ugly.
All right, now I don't see why I'd lie about the description of this lady, so...
What was your impression of her?
Kind of harried and harassed. In a hurry to go somewhere, but no place to go. You get to know the type.
Yeah, because she was selling a fucking stolen car.
Do you know anything about the company that prints these pink slips?
Nope. Should I? It isn't exactly my business.
All right, and he's fucking leaning forward and... I mean, it looks like he's telling the truth, right? And... Alright, I might be kicking myself. Oh, nailed it. Nice.
It says Marquee Printing. You've never heard of them?
Marquee. Sure. They do all the government red tape. You'll find the place down on Aliso Street near San Pedro.
Alright.
When exactly did you hand over the check, Mr. Combs?
Close of play on Friday.
Alright, well, he's clearly fucking lying, so... Boosh!
Why didn't you pay her cash? You knew the car was dirty.
I had an inkling. When people are in a hurry for money, always pay by check, son. Gives you a couple
inkling,
days to
huh?
back out.
What are you, a comic books artist, huh? Are you an inker? Do you ink pages after the penciler's done penciling the comics? Is that what you do? I already heard that
You're
one.
You're as thick as a whale sandwich, aren't
Seriously.
You, son?
Oh my god, it won't let me... Pick. Okay. Oh, there we go.
This was all above board.
Yes. Of course it was.
All right.
Did this look legitimate to you,
Coombs?
I'm in used cars, son. Not bearer bonds. In my business, you don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Now don't come on
Unless
all high and mighty with me if you want my help.
Are you a horse dentist, you fucking asshole?
Thanks for your help, Mr. Coombs. We need to continue the investigation.
Hope you sort out your problem with Mr. Harrison. Go easy on him, son. Boy's about as sharp as a bowling ball. He's built too low. The fastballs fly over his head.
Let me shoot this guy, please. You have a pleasant day, Mr. Cook.
He has a lot of interesting metaphors. Okay.
Well, Harrison might be off the hook, but we can still run an APB on Gene Archer. Get on
Don't
the horn and
what
call
to
it
do,
in.
You fucking jerk. All right, where's the phone? Yeah. Right. Wonder if they'll ever let us play LA Fire Department. That way we can use the red phone
Phelps,
box
one, two,
of the
four,
blue
seven.
One.
How could I help, Detective?
requesting an APB on Gene Archer, age approximately 25, on suspicion of Grand Theft Auto.
I'll relay the information.
Are there any messages for me?
James Belasco is being held at Central Station on suspicion of GTA. Possible link to the Harrison case. They're waiting on you to conduct the interview.
Mm-hmm. Thanks, ma'am.
So, we've got another suspect. But before we... before we do that, I really need to get a little revenge.
Hey, hey, hey! What the hell are you doing?
A hand grenade and a barrel of oatmeal.
Oh, yeah. Nice. What is this, a hearse?
Hey, hey, hey! What the hell are you doing?
Get out of the way, you fucking jerk.
I like to think it, Phelps. Call it evidence. The guy's an asshole. You can pick it up at the pound.
Let's do this one, too.
Hey, hey, hey! What the hell are you doing?
Nice. I couldn't see where I was going. There was a fucking sign in the thing. Do I really want any of these fucking things? I think I'll take this one, actually.
Hey, hey, hey! What the hell are you doing?
Hey.
Here's a chicken and egg question for you. Do you think you have to be an asshole to sell cars? Or that selling cars turns you into an asshole?
You've got it in for everyone today, haven't you?
I've always got it in for car salesmen. Doesn't matter what day it is. And why do they always think they're comedians when they're about as funny as a heart attack?
Maybe the more annoying they are, the quicker you sign on the dotted line, just to get the hell out of there.
Die! You're gonna kill
someone! I don't care about anyone. I'm a loose cannon. A cop on the edge with nothing to lose. I don't really know where I'm going, but that's okay, I think.
Woohoo! Oh, unbelievable!
So, I was thinking about this game, and I was thinking about how much I'd like to finish this game. Not because I'm not enjoying it, but because, well, a sequel to one of my favorite games is coming out in the fall.
Thank you.
So I'd like to do a playthrough of the previous game before I play the new game, you know what I mean? I guess I'll take it right up here. Probably could take that other right, but whatever. Oh, nice! Oh, boy. Die, lady. What? Did you see that?
Jesus,
like, it jumped right over my car. That was weird. Huh. Oh well.
Detectives, Belasco is prepped and ready in two. Another stolen car with legit papers.
Thanks. Yeah, stolen car. Who does that anyway? Steals cars.
I can bust in there and find the goddamn.
All right, I think two is over here, right? Yeah, there we go.
Are we going to the Mocambo this Friday?
I'm just what'd
you just fucking call me? Piece of shit.
James Belasco?
I want a lawyer. It's my car and I got the proof right here. Take a look for yourself.
Alright, tough guy. Let me look at this shit.
The paper is real enough, Belasco, but the car isn't yours. This pink slip is a forgery.
Okay, so apparently this James Belasco motherfucker lives at 146 North Fremont Ave? That's the same place that other lady lives, Jean Archer. This guy doesn't really look like the type to have a girlfriend, so... it's kind of suspicious. There's nothing on this. Okay. Yeah, you want to put that down? Alright, thanks. Alright, 25. Look at this motherfucker. Alright. Stolen auto courier.
Where were you taking the car, James?
Blow it off, greenhorn. You'll get nothing from me.
I'm not greenhorn. I'm a seasoned professional. Alright, He's obviously lying, but not really sure. Let's see. Receipt. Ownership papers. Okay. Well, we do have a note that 146 North Avenue, but that's not really evidence, right? I mean, just because the address on the pink slip is 146 doesn't mean... Well, let's just accuse him of a lie and see what he says.
You were taking the car to Coombs' car yard.
Oh.
He gives you cash, and the car's getting new papers.
Who the fuck is Coombs? What are you talking about?
Okay.
Sorry?
One thing you learn in this game is that you can eliminate the lying option by listening to what Cole says.
You're a two-time loser. If you don't give me something, I'm gonna ask the DA for the maximum. You're looking at 10 years, Belasco. Kiss your youth goodbye.
I want a deal.
Keep talking and we'll see what sort of deal you're worth.
My job is to drive the cars out of state. Nevada, Arizona, sometimes New Mexico. With the paperwork they provide, it's normally a breeze.
Mm-hmm. Normally. Well, something went wrong. You're starting to crack, Archer. I mean, whoever the fuck you are, Belasco.
Does the name Gene Archer mean anything to you?
Nope.
Okay, that's obviously a fucking lie, but let's see what lying Cole has to say. Mm-hmm.
You're a liar, James.
Say that again. I'm telling the truth. I don't know the broad.
Well, they have the same address. But is that enough to say that, I don't know how clever this game wants me to be. Shit.
It's like I made a mistake.
I'm gonna go with doubt, but if I'm wrong, I'm gonna hate the shit out of this game. Fuck!
You
motherfucker.
You want my partner here to convince you that you do know her?
I'm giving you the straight dope. I don't know Gene Archer.
That pisses me off. Okay. All right, Nick Meister, stay cool, stay calm.
What happens to the cars once they cross over the state lines?
I don't know. I just deliver them.
All right, I'm going to use doubt again. Yes, okay, good.
Give me something to laugh at.
All right, Nick Meister, you're back on top.
The whole station, you're a child molester. How long do you think you'll last?
Okay, I hear you. The cars get sold in Chicago or back east. Sometimes I bring back cars coming the other way.
Where are the stolen cars kept, you motherfucker?
Where do you pick up the cars, Belasco?
Warehouses. Mainly in the east downtown.
Alright, well, he's not being forthcoming.
You're lying, Belasco. You steal the cars yourself and then provide them to the ring.
I'd like to see you prove
that. Right.
Copper.
Well, that's obviously not the case.
It's nothing personal.
Sorry, this game play is not going
you
smoother, but
that.
Like I said, it's been a long time since I played this case.
An address, Belasco. You want my help with the DA? Cough it up now.
A place on Industrial Street. I don't know the number. You're gonna help me out,
I'm
right?
Hope you to
keep
get
talking,
a
kid.
Nice cozy we'll cell with a big do. Motherfucker. Would you like that?
All right, James. We're going to check if this information is worth anything.
And if it is, I need your help here, pal.
If it is, then we'll know you're a man of your word. And so will the DA.
Which means absolutely nothing.
You're Phelps, right?
Yes, I am. Look, can we do this later? I'm in the middle of
Ray Pinker. I'm with Technical Services. The pink slips are all real.
Yes, we know that.
There's only one company that prints them in California. The Marquee Printing Company. They've confirmed that the numbers are legitimate.
You've checked them out?
Sure. They're on Aliso Street near the corner of San Pedro. The guy I spoke to was Lightvall. Gordon Lightvall. Here. I wrote it down.
All right.
Thanks, Ray. This is a great lead.
Yeah,
we'll
I kind of already knew all this shit, but thanks anyway. You nerd. Ray Pinker. What kind of name is that, huh?
Your GTA suspect, Gene Archer, spotted by a patrolman. Western Union office, 253 South Hill. Less than a minute away down the street if you run. Go!
You kind of make me uncomfortable when you do that, pal.
The guy gave his wife a tap. I said, all's fair and love.
Alright. Hopefully I can see where I'm going. No, no, we don't really have time to wait for you. Sorry.
Come
yeah.
on. You don't want to lose them.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Get out of my fucking way. No hot dog stand is safe when Cole Phelps is around.
It'll only take a little while.
My acting coach is quite a lot of money.
Real talent.
What is taking so goddamn...
LAPD. We'll take it from here.
God damn it. Everyone's against me. Look, just let me get my money and get out of here, okay? You look sweet. How about giving a girl a break? I could be very nice.
Afraid I can't do that, Miss Archer. Stefan, call for black and white.
Just my luck to get the only hair shirt cop in the LAPD.
Hair shirt. Is that like a derogatory term for a homosexual? Because that's the first time I've heard that. Anyway.
The car you sold to Coombs was stolen, Miss Archer. There won't be any money.
I handed over all the right paperwork when I sold it, Buster.
Okay. See, okay, let's just... There's like so many... That's a problem with this part, this case in particular. There's just so many things that she's clearly full, so full of shit. It's like, what do you pick, right?
Lying, Jean.
You want to prove that, Buster? Try and prove that pink slip is not real.
Okay, well, the pink slip is real. That's not the fucking problem. I guess if I had gotten Belasco to... Shit. Fuck. Multiple pink slips found obsession. Oh, come on!
Look, this is all just a big mistake. I don't want to talk anymore. Just let
fuck
me
you,
go.
Bitch. I mean... There's, like, so many different things. So many different things. It shows that she's clearly full of fucking shit. But the game wants you to pick one specific thing. It doesn't make any sense.
How long have you and Belasco been delivering cars?
Who is James
Belasco?
All right,
you're full of fucking shit.
You're lying. James Belasco. I don't remember mentioning his first name, Miss Archer.
Oh, I... Well, I think you did, didn't you? Well, I'm sure of it. Anyway, I don't know him.
See, the thing is, she already proved she's lying, so why do you gotta point to evidence? It doesn't make any sense. What the fuck? So this one? Legitimate pink slip may not the... Okay, good. Starting
well,
to get pissed off.
Machine. You and James Belasco share the same address on your pink slips.
Yeah.
We have him in a cell.
Okay, so I know the creep. The pink slips are real. The home addresses mm-hmm. are always vacant lots. Bigelow is always boasting that the paperwork is legit and that if we stick to our stories...
And don't try and sell the car?
Yeah, that too.
Okay.
Tell me where you picked up the car, Miss Archer.
Look, I can't remember. Let me go, will you? Please. What have I got to
Lady,
do?
Lady, there's nothing you can do that I want. Let's see what he says when it's a lie.
You're lying. You remember just fine.
And how exactly do you know that?
I don't think we have any evidence. No, I guess we don't really have any evidence of that, so...
You don't ask, you never find out.
I guess it should be doubt. Okay, good.
Trying my patience here, Gene. I'll have the reporters down here and have your picture in all the papers.
Mm-hmm.
You'll have nowhere to run.
All right, already.
In that fucking
hat. I get
hat,
the message.
You'll never live it down.
I pick up the cars from a guy named Bigelow. 58 Industrial Street.
Bam Bam Bigelow?
Big warehouse.
You mean that pro wrestler?
Now you've got what you want.
You can
can
go to jail, you fucking lady.
Please?
No, you sure can. We've got a car waiting outside for you.
Some career advice, Gene. Get out of crime. Marry someone boring who has money and will find you captivating.
Is this guy for real?
He takes a little getting used to, but yeah, he generally means what he says.
Get in there, you and your fucking hat. How does it even stay on your head? You must have an odd-shaped head. You must have, like, a pointy end. That's the way my head was when I was first born. And I squeezed out.
He'll never find
it. Okay. That was frustrating, but I got 2 out of 3. Not bad, not bad.
My acting coach says I have real talent.
You know the way. You can drive. So, where you want to go?
Now, little spoilers here, but if we go here, something big's gonna go down, so... maybe we should go... here first, I guess. Nah, we're gonna go there. Yeah, I'm gonna go here first. Or maybe I should... Decisions. Eeny, meeny, miny, you know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna go here first. No. I'm gonna go here first. Okay. Let's go. God, being a Let's Player is so fucking hard. So many hard decisions to make.
Friendly girl.
Used to getting her own way.
Little did she know her feminine charms were useless against the impenetrable Cole Phelps.
She's not my type.
And what is your type, Phelps?
I'm married.
I know that. But you're not blind or dead inside, are you? Wait, scrap that second half of the question.
I don't know. Blondes, I guess.
Hallelujah! The man is human after all. Now we're getting somewhere. Yep, I'm with you on the blondes. Brunettes are fine, too. And there's nothing wrong with a good redhead. But I draw the line at gray. You know what? I might have to lift that embargo soon in the interest of maintaining a free market.
A man with high standards.
The standards are only as high as the last glass of whiskey.
Yep. Got that one straight off a PUA webpage. Website, whatever.
I think we should call for a couple of black and whites. Get Fleischer down here.
I thought you Marines were gung-ho, Cole. You have a 45, don't you ever want to use it? I'll take the back. Just give me a few seconds to get around.
Out for blood. Actually... by the end of this game, Cole Phelps will rack up quite a kill count.
Cole Phelps, LAPD. All of you are coming downtown with me.
Haha. Awesome.
Look sharp, it's a cop.
Throw out the guns.
I don't like the way Cole Phelps screams.
I'm gonna put holes in you, asshole.
Sounds like our partner's getting his ass kicked.
You're moving, bitch.
He's still not dead? Seriously? Come on, Dad. Don't tell me what to do, guy. Die, die, die.
Really hurts.
die, you motherfucker!
Let's clear the top floor. I don't want to get drilled in the back on the way out.
Weapons on the ground!
Nice. Die, you motherfucker! Die, you motherfucker! That was a close one.
By the door at the end. I heard something.
Oh, wow, he had a black guy working for him. He's very, very progressive for a gangster. It's good to know. Die! Die! I'll cut out, I'll cut it out.
Alright, don't shoot!
Keep your hands up. Watch him, Bukowski. He doesn't move until I've tossed this place.
Alright, let's look around. See what we can see. What's this shit here?
A betting slip. Looks like Mr. Lightfall has been on a losing
Lightfall.
Streak.
Well, if Lightfall does control the pink slips and he is owing some people a lot of money, it wouldn't make sense for him to do this shit. Gordon Lightfall.
Marquee Printing Company. There's nothing like going direct to the source.
Alright. Is there anything else around here?
There are enough slips here to keep them stealing cars till Christmas. We've got a trail of pink slips and stolen cars that leads right to your door, Bigelow. You're in this up to your neck. But I don't think
should have stayed pro wrestling, you motherfucker.
Give him up.
I had to work on cars for customers. You charge in here shooting up the place like it's the Ballad of Bulge.
I'll give you a bulge right in my pants. Alright.
We know about Marquee Printing. You can make this easier on yourself by giving us your man on the inside.
I sometimes repair cars and put them back on the road. I need a pink slip to resell them. There's no problem there.
Okay, I wasn't even paying attention. Sorry. let's see here. Blah blah. We know about Marquee Printing. You can easier. Well, I'm just clearly lying, but what's that lying face is hilarious. Okay.
Don't lie to me. I'm not in the mood for any more lies.
The slips are the real deal, and I order them from Marquee.
Well, they are. Whether they're real or not isn't really the issue, right? The issue is, I mean, goddamn, there's so much shit here. Okay. I'm gonna doubt this guy, but I think it's wrong, and I don't really know why. I wish I'd prepared for this, you know? Oh, nice.
There are at least 4 dead men in this warehouse. A couple more. Punks won't make for that much extra paperwork. We'd be doing the legal system a favor.
Okay, tough guy. I get the message. Lightfall. The guy who runs Marquee. He's the big shot. He likes to spend big at the track. He owes people.
Right, gambling debts. Another clue. Maybe we should have talked to Lightfall before we went here. Oh well.
Lightfall, the guy with no luck at the track. Tell me about him.
It's one of the guys lying over there. You're right. He has no luck.
Okay. Let's see what. I know I always do this, but.
That's the best lie you can come up with, Bigelow?
Hey, would I lie to you, Detective? I'm not exactly in a good position here now, am I?
Well, I mean, we know why the fuck with Lightfall. The guy who works at the printing company be, you know, in This doesn't make any sense, right? I mean, note from Ray Pinker. I mean, fuck.
You're off the hook.
Doubt again.
For now.
Oh, man.
So if I go over there and check his jacket, your story's gonna ring true? I'm warning you, Bigelow.
Give it a try, Flatfoot. For some reason, none of my guys like to bring ID to work.
Whether you give up your bosses or not, Bigelow, you're going away for as long as I can put you there.
We'll see. I didn't fire a shot, copper. I just watched you tear my place up.
All right, I guess I should have picked a note from Ray Pinker. I mean, we know he works at the fucking printing company. It's stupid. But that's the thing, I mean, you can't just go, douchebag, we know that this guy works here. He wouldn't be in your fucking shop, but can't do that because it's a video game. All right, I think this is the last case I'm going to do blind because I'm going to go blind with rage. If I have to, put up with... Wow, those guys are sturdy as a rock.
Can you drive to this one?
Last place to go is the printing company.
All right.
Wrap this whole thing up. Send Lightfall to jail.
What a mess.
Gonna take some cleaning up, that's for sure.
I wish it hadn't gone that way.
Well, they shouldn't bring guns to work with them. We didn't have a lot of choice.
You have to admire the barefaced cheek of someone who tries to blow your brains out one minute, and then pleads innocence the next.
Yeah, especially when he's surrounded by evidence. If guys like Bigelow spend so much time convincing themselves that they're not doing anything wrong, that they actually start to believe their own bullshit.
They get sloppy. Bigelow, Lightfall, all of them. If they hadn't, who knows how long they could have kept this racket going.
Complacency or greed. It's always one of the two that brings them down.
Wow, nice job parking, you guy. Can't believe you did that. Alright.
You're under arrest.
I'm sorry, just what the hell are you talking about?
Talking about putting you under arrest.
We found a box of pink slips in a warehouse full of hot cars. You signed for them, Lightbulb.
I signed for all the orders and deliveries. You'll need something better than that, cowboy.
Save it, Lightfall. We already have all we need to send you down.
I've had enough of this. You either produce some shred of proof, or I call my attorney.
I think the right clue here is the gambling debts, but not quite sure. Hold on a second. Is that it? I mean, that would make sense, right? Oh, well, Bigelow testifies. Oh, nice. Good.
You're in the hole with the organization. We know about the debts, Lightfall.
I agree. I have a small problem. I'm prepared to help you in any way I can, Detective. I'll name names. I need you to keep this out of the paper.
You need to shut up now, Lightfall. Gordon Lightfall, I'm charging you with conspiracy and fraud.
I think there are more questions if you talk to him before you go to Bigelow, but, you know, I fucked that up.
The LAPD Central Traffic Division has today smashed a nationwide auto theft ring, writes crime correspondent, blah, blah, blah. Oh, here it is. Traffic squad detectives confronted a large group of armed thugs after an exchange of gunfire. More than a dozen dead criminals were removed from the scene. The LAPD sustained no casualties.
Wow.
Damn
must be
fine
the late edition.
Work, Phelps. Now get out there and nail some more bad guys, will you? I want to finish reading.
I mean, seriously,
this.
Like, how... I mean, do they just go back to that place, like, the day after? Probably not, right? Huh. Well, that's a slip of the tongue. Hey, I only missed 3 questions. And I only did $1,500 worth of damage. I still only got 3. Huh. Clues. I think the 2 clues I missed was in the printing company. I should have gone there before the, you know, before the warehouse shootout. But I wanted to streamline the playthrough, because if you go to Light Vault first, you visit them twice. Yeah, it would have flipped if encouraged. So I fucked up there. Oh well.